if I take an iron supplement and I get my levels up to normal, does that now mean I can stop supplementing with iron? Or do I need to keep supplementing with iron for the rest of my life to maintain, you know, awesome levels, optimal levels of iron? Hit that subscribe button, check that little bell to be notified when there's a new video. And as always, you know, if you have a question, often I'll make a video related to that question you asked, because this question, this is from a person who asked this question, the one we're answering today. But I'll be in the comment section for about 30 minutes and, you know, answer questions and go over, you know, any things that might be bogging you down related to iron and the ability to optimize your levels there. So the simple answer is no. Usually you don't have to stay on iron for the rest of your life. And, you know, if you're not losing blood via menstruation or the digestive tract, you're not pregnant, you're not an avid runner, and you're not vegan or vegetarian, then it is likely you will need to supplement with iron once your levels are normalized, because your lifestyle predisposes you to low iron levels, to excessively either losing it or using it. So generally, my normalized iron levels would mean a ferritin between about 70 and 120 micrograms per liter. If, of course, you have an underlying chronic inflammatory illness, you have, you know, cancer, you have lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, you've been on some, you know, methotrexates or some hardcore medications, then your ferritin may be an unreliable marker as to your iron status. And you really want to pull an iron saturation, you want to look at your total iron binding capacity. You know, the value of those is really going to go up. I mean, I would look at those either way. I always, you know, if you're going to get ferritin checked, get your iron, get your TIBC, get your iron saturation check, get your seroplasmin check, get a CBC done, do them all at the same time, every time. If you are a menstruating female and it has been deemed that the reason your iron level is low is because of, you know, your monthly blood loss during your period, basically exceeding your ability to extract sufficient iron from your food, then often in my patients, we'll have them take or continue to take iron during the days of their period, so the days of bleeding, because iron absorption is most efficient at that time of the woman's cycle. And this increase in efficiency can be anywhere between like about 1.5 and 3 times. So, you know, it's a lot easier to extract the iron from the food, from the supplements during this time frame. So that's a great time to have your hamburger, have your steaks, or take your supplement. Of course, we would also consider, you know, natural measures to reduce overall bleeding during the menstrual period, you know, to minimize that iron loss, that blood loss that's happening there. However, I would also say, literally given the uniqueness of each woman, a heavy period or a light period does not decide whether or not that woman is going to be iron deficient or iron sufficient. You could be a heavy bleeder and your body to figure out a way to maintain iron stores. You could be a light bleeder and your body has challenges pulling enough iron into to compensate. So there's so many other things to consider. This is why testing your levels is so desirable, to know where you stand. Now, if you are an avid runner or endurance athlete, or you have digestive issues, maybe multiple food intolerances, or like I said, celiac disease, it is important, or H. pylori, it's important to consistently check your iron levels to make sure you are maintaining. Because you really want to catch any drops in your iron, in any, you know, big falls before you actually experience symptoms of iron deficiency. Because by that time, you know, it's like, fatigue, headaches, depression, brain fog, you know, all that stuff's happening. So for instance, I had a patient recently where their ferritin levels over about a 4-month time frame had dropped from 125 to 40. That's a significant drop. And, you know, if we weren't supporting them, if they didn't start supporting themselves, you know, over the next 3 months, the person would probably be in a state of significant iron deficiency. And, you know, all the symptoms would really start percolating. So you don't have to wait for a disease process to present itself to start supporting your body. And, you know, if you've been iron deficient, which that's usually the reason most people get on iron supplementation is because they were iron deficient, I think it's wise to check your levels about every 3 months, you know, once you've normalized, and do that for about a year. just to see what are the ups and downs of your iron levels. And if you're a lady menstruating, you know, do it at the same time your cycle, each cycle. Otherwise, you know, if you do it during your period, if you do it at the, you know, end of your cycle, you're not really getting a consistent measure for yourself. And, you know, once you can see what your normals are, then you can start stretching that out or you know, like the 6 to 9 months before checking again. Or you might find that, shoot, you know, I'm going to keep this 3 month thing going because my levels are not, you know, stay normal. I'm dropping kind of thing. I would also mention that while getting iron levels normalized, you know, via iron supplementation, my favorite being blood vitality, it is important to look at the underlying, you know, conflict that is causing iron to be low in the first place. You know, if the cause is never taken care of, you're likely going to find yourself on iron supplementation for a long, long time. And you're just always going to feel better if it's consistently, you know, essentially being modulated and the body itself is taking care of iron versus always having to supplement. There's, of course, a great reason to supplement. You got to get your levels up. Otherwise, you're not going to feel well. But I'm Dr. Matt. You can check the link below for my iron guide. It's free. You know, let me know your iron story. What have you found to be the main cause of your iron deficiency? How have you found your iron levels to be maintained most efficiently? And I'd love to hear how it's going for you. And I'll talk to you guys and gals later.